There are many reasons that a controller might want to write policy to change the state in the network switches, including maintenance, unexpected failure, and traffic engineering. Any of these network tasks involve or require updating state in the network switches. And when that state transition happens, we want to make sure that forwarding remains correct and consistent. In particular, we would like to maintain the following invariants. There shouldn't be any forwarding loops, and there shouldn't be any black holes whereby a router or switch receives a packet and doesn't know what to do with it. There also shouldn't be cases where traffic is going where it shouldn't be allowed to go because of the network being in an inconsistent state. Let's now consider an example of what might happen when policies are written to the network if they're written in an inconsistent fashion. Let's consider a case where we have a network that is performing shortest paths routing to some destination, and the link weights are as I've shown here in the figure. Traffic in the network would flow along the paths shown in green. Let's suppose now that an operator wants to change the network state to shift traffic off of this link. He could do so by updating the link weight. In doing so, the new shortest path from this top router would be as follows. But what if the state in the top switch occurred before the state in the bottom switch could be updated? In this case, we would have a potential forwarding loop. Traffic would proceed to the bottom switch, but the bottom switch would still have the old network state and would continue to forward traffic to the top switch, resulting in a forwarding loop. If rules are installed along a path out of order, packets may reach a switch before the new rules do. So in this type of model, we would have to think about all possible packet and event orderings to ensure that consistent behavior resulted. So we need atomic updates of the entire configuration. The solution to this problem is to use a two-phase commit so that packets are either subjected to the old configuration on all switches or to the new configuration on all switches. But packets aren't subjected to the new policy on some switches and the old policy on others. The idea is to tag the packet on ingress so that the switches maintain copies of both P1 and P2 for some time. When all switches have received rules corresponding to the new policy, then incoming packets can be tagged with P2. After some time, when we're sure that no more packets with P1 are being forwarded through the network, we can only then remove the rules corresponding to policy P1. Now, the naive version of two-phase commit requires doing this on all switches at once, which essentially doubles the rule space requirements, since we have to store the rules for both P1 and P2. We can limit the scope of the two-phase commit by only applying this mechanism on switches that involve the affected portions of the traffic or the affected portions of the topology.